Well, it seems like everyone is feeling a little winter fatigue. January, which is finally over, continued to be cold and snowy across much of the state. It's a trend that we've been seeing all across Colorado. Meteorologist Corey Reppenhagen takes a look at the numbers and shows how it fits into the climate change conversation.
This January was the 17th coldest in Denver history. It's only the second time in the 21st century that January's been that cold. It was also the 15th snowiest in Denver history. Only the third time in the last 30 years there's been more than a foot of snow in the month of January. And it's been that way now for 3 months. November and December were also snowier and colder than average. Same story in Boulder, Evergreen, Greeley, and Fort Collins. Cold and snowy. On the northeastern plains, it's been the snowiest winter on record in Akron and Julesburg, second snowiest in Sterling, and the third snowiest in Holyoke. Mountain snowpack is 31% above average, the highest it's been at the end of January in 6 years. So how does a big winter like this fit into the climate change conversation when projections show warmer and less snowy winters in Colorado's future? Well, one winter can't show how the climate is changing because it's not a long enough time period. You have to look at several winters to determine a climate trend. 30-year periods are best. Let's use snowpack as an example. 12 out of the last 30 winters in Colorado have brought above average snow, like this season could end up being. That's a lot of snowy winters, but the climate trend is showing that there have been more below average winters. And the dry winters have been way more extreme than the snowy ones. Over the last 30 years, Colorado snowpack has decreased by more than 40%.
Winter's not over yet, though. There are still 2.5 months left in the mountain snowpack accumulation season. The chances are pretty high that we'll finish at least average or above, but nothing's guaranteed with our weather in Colorado.